There's a great echo in the room.
Oh.
space field, wherever we are. We're going to close our eyes and try to make one tone with our voices. Okay. Should we? Thank you. So the one group will be the one asking questions. I think this group will ask questions. And it's going to go following. One person will, let's say you, will ask a question to one of us. You can choose whoever you want to ask the question to. And the other person has to answer. Now, if the person answering does not want to answer the question, then someone else
has to answer. According to their opinion or their background, etc. And the next person who is going to ask a question can ask a different question, whatever they want. But if they don't have something specific in mind, they can ask why to the person that answered previously. Is this clear or should I repeat? So, one person asks a question, another person answers. Or if they don't want to answer, another one answers for them. And then the next person in line asks another question. If they don't know exactly, or if they don't have something specific in mind to ask, they ask why to the person that answers. For example, where are you from? I am from Greece. Why are you from Greece? Because my parents lived in Greece before me. Like, okay, simply. So the only rule of this game is that questions must be asked and answers must be given.
Question for you. When was the last time you watched the sunrise?
Before my son was born.
Or you ask a question anybody you want, or if you don't have anything in mind, you ask why the same person.
Why did you see the sunrise?
Just one.
Why?
Why?
I think I kind of lied before, because I guess I probably saw the sunrise when my son was awake at night in the middle of the day, but I didn't pay attention to the sunrise.
Why?
I pay attention to the sunrise because he was probably crying very hard. But actually, all of this might be not true. I'm not sure. I actually can't remember the last time I saw the sunrise, so it's really hard. I feel like I'm making it up now.
What means community for you?
Let's say it's an in-between.
Why?
let's say for example, we are a group of people here. If we find the thing we share, let's say, and like we have in, the thing we have in common, is just like that being a lot of people together that defines a community.
What do you think about this experience?
What do you think about this experience?
Me?
Yeah.
I am very curious what is happening with us.
How are you?
Thanks, I'm fine.
Super.
I'm happy here at this moment, yes. Because it's a special moment with the sound and we sing a little. It's a very special moment for me, yes. Some minutes before. That was very, very nice and emotional moment, yes.
Did you know about this experiment?
Well, I read about it online, and I just made time to come here, right at 6.
Why?
Because I just arrived in Cassel, and I wanted to do something that I could spend some time, but not that tiring. So I'm here.
Can we all speak up a little bit? Speak a little bit louder.
Please, what do you think about the great picture outside with the knitting belts?
is very interesting, and about sea and water and old time with the ship to round about war, I think, or I don't know. I am okay with this hobby.
Do you think it's art?
Yes.
Why?
Because the world is full of like experiences and moments that everybody has to experience by themselves.
Why?
I think because everybody experiences everything in a different way, so everybody has to like get in the situation and live the moment for his or herself.
What is yourself?
Sorry?
What is yourself?
Ah, I think I cannot define that. I cannot explain you what is myself.
So someone else can answer? So someone else can answer the question?
What's the question?
What is yourself?
What is yourself?
Yes, this is the question.
I'm not a limit, but I cannot define myself being that. It's too fluid maybe just to be just a definition.
So what does it mean?
We are constantly in movement, I guess. So maybe I must tell you this today, but tomorrow I will be someone else. I don't know why. We are leaving.
Should we try start again? Once more?
Question for you. The last time a book made you think... The last time you read a book that really made you think and question, or artwork,
last time I read a book that made me think about something that moved me. Oh, I don't know the title. It was about the zero field. That means the energy field that. Out of that, it's everything wrong.
Why?
Why? Why everything is born out of that? It's like a sea of potential. Out of that, everything can be born. Either you have something in mind and you're creating out of that something. Just happens.
When did you decide to be part of this performance?
Why?
Just now, you think?
What makes you happy?
Just now?
Now?
In the moment, yeah.
In the moment,
yeah. And I like anything.
Oh, to be together with other people, I like it. I feel good, yeah. But now it's a little bit difficult because I would answer in German, but I have to answer in English, that's the problem.
Sometimes I just want to be, you know, be in a very quiet moment and be by myself because I live in a very big city and there's not much chance of being alone. So it's silence is good.
Okay, now this team asks the questions.
What do you think a performance should be?
Authentic.
Mm-hmm.
Authentic. That's it.
What do you think about this experience, this performance here? How do you feel?
I don't know yet. Why? What I think about it, so we're not allowed to ask questions. Because you're already here.
Yeah.
Ah.
You have a feeling in some.
But he didn't ask what I feel, he
what
asked
fear,
what I
yes.
think. And I don't know what I think right now.
Okay,
I
feel
it's
fear, yeah.
Founded.
Yeah.
It's nice being here, although I'm a little bit confused. And I wonder why we speak so little. But I myself, because you said authentic, feel like being silent, so I think that's the way I feel. And to allow myself to be silent if I feel like that.
Are you interested in art?
Yes, I am.
Why?
because I like the way that art merges with my research interests. I like working by myself and researching with the tools of art.
Why?
Because it's the only thing I can do, actually.
She was asking, is it with you being here, the feeling, do you feel like a complete stranger?
No, because I'm always on stage, so for me that's, I feel like home.
Why are you always a stranger?
Sorry, why? Why I feel like normal? Because I also live on stage. I love when people look at me. Yeah. Or I don't have a problem with it. I went, like every artist on stage, of course, you suffer a lot. But if you survive, something, yeah. So there's no difference between life and stage. Yes. There are no differences anymore. I'm very happy.
Favorite song? The second movement of Beethoven's Third Symphony.
Can you sing it?
No, there's no. It's just orchestral.
With Nana.
While we are all together, would you like us to do or to experiment something particular together? I mean, all the time together?
Can you repeat it?
While we are all together, would you like us to do or to experiment something? All of us?
I like to. Use the tone of our voices, and I would like to interact more with our voices, like all together.
Can you give us instructions to do that?
I could. We can maybe all make the highest tone we can do.
Watching this online, what would you type into the comments? What would you type?
Oh, at the moment I don't know, right. Because it's not finished.
But you could type anything.
There are also live comments.
Yes.
While it's...
Oh, okay, I didn't know that. What would I type? I don't know. I would type, it's a little bit stiff.
Can you bring someone? Huh? Can you bring someone?
No, I don't know.
Can you?
I can.
Sure.
Let me just feel what you feel in your body and see how that moves to me. Thank you.
Now we can build a scale from 1 to 10. If 1 is there and 10 is at the other wall, how much instrumentalized we felt in this concert? How much instrumentalized we felt because of the questions being asked and the movements? And how much we think that we are influenced by what it was said? And if you feel a lot, very instrumentalized, you go at 10. If you feel that you were free to choose whatever you want to do, you go at 1.
In the whole, from the beginning?
Yes. Could we have the same scale about our everyday lives? In our everyday lives, how much instrumentalized we feel? From 1 to 10 again. Not in this concert, but in everyday life. The question is how much instrumentalized you feel in your everyday life. How much you can choose what you can do, and you have agency upon what you are doing. Can you explain? You are the most free person in the room. Can you tell us?
we say I'm out of work. Mm-hmm. The fact. My company pays me until I go to the
pensions.
Go to the zum Ruhestand, the Rente.
Retirement.
Yes, and so I can do whatever I want. I don't have to work to earn money at this time. So I can do what I will. That's a very special time.
It's a very privileged position you have. Yes. But you, what do you do in your life? But you feel free that you can do many things.
Yes. Okay.
You also? You feel,
Yes. I am free. I am many times in three around the world. And I enjoy my life.
But you feel you all for you are the most. So what do you do? What do you do in your everyday life? Why you feel?
Let's say it's like a game at some point. You know, it's like because at the end of the day you still have to go, for example, to work. You have hours, etc. But you can still also see the limits of what you can do, what you can do. And at some point it's like a game. You just play with the limits.
So what are you doing to your freedom. An example.
A concrete example?
Yeah.
A very concrete one, let's say.
Yeah.
For example, with money. Like if I want to travel or to do something, it's like, imagine to travel. I was just trying to find a way how can I do it with my own expenses and just to make it happen.
What does it mean with your own expenses?
I mean like a very like basic level of, I don't know, find like cheap flights or something like that. We have our own context sometimes, like with our work, with our money, with the city where we live, with etc.
Yes, but travel, for example.
Yeah.
Why do you travel?
Sorry?
Why do you travel?
Why do I travel? Well, for a lot of things. Let's say like for curiosity, to meet my family because I don't live in the same country, to be here with you guys right now, discover the documenta, to share a moment with a friend. To experiment.
Why?
Because I like that, and I'm curious. To leave this experience with you, to spend some time with one person, to also see different realities, and to understand also better, for example, when I've been to Lebanon or to Israel, to understand even better a context
of the political situation.
Of political situation and
social
also,
situation.
Yeah, for example. Well, a lot of things.
Why? Why do you understand it better?
Because when you speak with the people who are there, for example, in the case of Lebanon, there are already new people, artists, who are living there. And I stayed with them for 2 weeks, and we're living together, and it happens some bomb attacks at the same moment. So, for example, me with my European very shocked about what's happening, and it was during the New Year's Eve, and I didn't understand why the people were like doing party for New Year's Eve, and the day before like over like 200 people died in the bomb attack, and then they explained it that they grew up during a civil war, and for them it's another reality, and it's interesting just to have this kind of conversation and to understand relation, context, and histories. Like, I think it's interesting. Like for you guys when you were answering the question, because it's interesting.
Yes.
For example, because you are quite on the extreme limit, in the same way. So why are you considering yourself instrumentalized?
I'm considering that we are all very much instrumentalized. And maybe if we pushed a little bit the whys, maybe we could find out some of the mediations that we all have. For example, I also, I work a lot and I don't have much free time in my everyday life, so my everyday life is very oriented and programmed, and so this is typical instrumentalization, let's say, but still I do some stuff that I really like and that are liberating in a way, like I do. Working in arts, or I am working with people in a very social environment, and blah blah blah. But also these, I don't think that I do it because I was warm, liking them. Like you, for example, traveling or being interested in knowing about other cultures. There is also a way that you turn to try to fulfill this image, in a way, maybe, or this state of living. So I feel that I'm instrumentalist even for being an artist. Like, for example, my uncle was an artist, and I was very inspired by him. And from my family, I was raised up in a sensitive way, blah, blah, blah. And this made me want to do all the things that I do in my everyday life. So.
But isn't it a difference to be instrumentalized and to be somehow determined or something? If you talk about instrumentalization, there's somebody or something that is instrumentalizing you.
Yes.
So there's another side, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I don't see it in your case. Like, was there somebody who said you're supposed to be an artist for me?
No, there's not. But there is an image of the artist in our urban everyday life and in our urban societies, which contains some stuff that I do. For example, being interested in social issues, or wanting to travel, or enjoying the works of art, or blah blah blah. This is all contained in an image of an intellectual artist that I have, and I want to fulfill in a way.
Yeah, but
it's maybe it's not the dominant image, but there is an image to me. I don't know.
But it's not somebody creating that image and you have to follow, so I think it's
there
not...
There is somebody creating that image.
Who?
Culture, society.
Mm.
I've seen it in the cinema.
Concerning our experience in this space, for example, how do you feel being here? What do you think of this experiment? Or and it seemed like a tried an effort to figure out what is happening and what are the structures of this experience we are going through. And I felt like the questions we were asking to each other were very much determined by the frame that we are working in. For example, if we all met in a cafe, we would have probably asked completely different questions. Maybe, what is your name? What do you do? What is your family status, for example, or your social status? Where are you from? But I think that the questions were generally directed to figure out what we are doing here. And also, this proposition with the sound, who was it? It was you who implemented it. So, and you said that you wanted us to all make sound together. And I wonder why you thought this was the best thing to do with other people. And if this has anything to do with the fact that we started by doing this with like warm up, where we listen to our voices and start the bassing around the room. So it was a bit, it seemed to me like everything we were saying was taken from the environment, the frame. And this is why I chose to stand here, because I think that we are very much determined by the frame we work inside. For example, you said you like to travel, but if you consider that, I think from your accent, I can tell that you're probably from France.
Yeah.
So you are, you live in a North European country, you are white, you have a passport, which means you can travel.
Mm-hmm.
If some at some point the state decides that you cannot have a passport anymore, then you cannot go away from France, for example. So I think the way we move and the way we make our choices is very much dependent on frames.
I also like this last part when we spoke about them. We started telling about what is our mediation that we are embedded in and we find more visible. And for me, that was my unconscious. I saw that my unconscious was taking a decision for me sometimes, and this is how I discovered how I'm maybe instrumentalized. I would have been at 8 or 9 or something like that. So I would like to ask you maybe what is your main, the thing that makes you more instrumentalized. So from what I heard, this thing is one very, very often that people say work. It's the main thing that instrumentalizes me. But I don't know, where would you like to tell me in which kind of mediation you are most embedded in and you feel most, that is the most difficult to get outside of?
But maybe, work or not work, but I think in every day, when you watch all the system, we are every day in a system for transport, loisir, I don't know if you said that.
Leisure.
Yeah, leisure, everything is a system that we are working on. It's very difficult to speak in English also. I can feel it through blah, blah, blah. And so it just, I can feel free if I have the impression to decide which kind of implication, personal implication, I can do in this kind of context. So I can feel instrumentalized when I take a bus, for example, because I didn't choose this system of transport. So it could be a lot of situations, in fact, if I don't have the impression to be sollicited. But I remember in French.
Isolated?
Yeah, no, like you speak about community, so when we speak about community, it's to be together and to decide the rule together. And today we are in democracy and there is some different person who takes decision for us, okay? And we choose this person. But in fact, the system is bigger than a few hierarchy. Mm-hmm. So every day I have the pressure to don't choose a lot of decision, in fact. Oh, okay, but it's a huge tweak. But, too much. But also this architecture also. It's an amazing architecture for this kind of experience. It's with concrete, it's very resonant. It's very difficult to speak together with unknown persons. So I have the impression to be instrumentalized in this place also, a lot.
Yeah. Do you think you can be instrumentalized by your privilege? I think a lot about my privilege and about removing my privilege. And so it's like everything has to start from a confession of the kind of expectations. And I mean, and this is in an art context as well. I think, you know, being male, being white, being English speaking as well, it feels like that's a kind of instrumentalized figure. But it's tricky. I don't know. I feel like I want to be outside of those things many times. But then at the same time, it must feel like, why would you want to be outside of those things for some people? Why would you want to be someone without a passport? And what would it mean to get out of those moments, that feeling of privilege? It's not a feeling, it's a state. It's the way people look at you, the way people treat you. I live in America, I speak with a British accent, I treat you differently than if I spoke with a Spanish accent. And
native, I'm not white, I'm not male. Well, my first language isn't English. Well, my parents paid a lot for me to have this accent, but...
Could you connect with the instrumental, that I'm instrumentalized by privilege? Or not, is that...
Well, comparably, well, I was, I think I am pretty privileged in my country in to being able to speak like this.
And what is your country?
I'm from South Korea.
Okay.
From Seoul.
Yeah.
Yes. But, and I've been raised by very educated people. And they expect certain things for you. And I wanted to get a tattoo since I was a teenager, but I never got one. Because I cannot show, I cannot have it on anywhere. It shows when you wear a dress or a t-shirt or something like that. So I don't have any tattoo. And
but now you run out. Do you have?
Well, still, I work at a place where a lot of people expect you to be a pretty, very well-mannered woman. So, well, in my country, so I cannot have tattoo, or I have to wear skirts that are longer than my knees at work, and that's not written in books or in the laws, but they expect me to wear makeup and wear a lot of monotone clothes. So it's different, but I don't think that a lot of people had what I had, and I sometimes know that it's very I don't know how to say that in English, but it feels very like too well fed, or I don't know, it's sometimes very, it sounds bad to say that loud or keep, you know, have it out of your mouth and let